Let's give credit where it's due. All right, telecom operators have done plenty for this country over the last decade.
They've allowed your chachaji to send in dirty SMS jokes all day long.
They've even tried to convince you that har ek friend zaruri hota hai.
You know what? Har ek friend zaruri nahi hota hai.
Some friends are matlabi and are only your friends because they want to play FIFA
and you're the only person they know who has an Xbox.
So tell your pretend friends to...
Anyway, the point is, if you're one of those three people in the country that actually likes your telecom operator, don't worry.
Because we finally have something that will push you over the edge.
Because right at this very minute, India's telecom companies are lobbying the Telecom Regulatory Authority of India to enact a regulation in a way that will change the way Indians are using the internet forever.
These telecom operators are going after something that's called net neutrality.
What is net neutrality? And why should I care?
Net neutrality means one. All content is equal and all sites must be equally accessible.
Net neutrality means that whether it's a Honey Singh
video or a breaking news report about a terrorist attack
or a cat gif,
all content on the internet is equal and must be equal always.
Whatever your choice, neutrality means that once you have an internet plan,
you should be allowed to access any website you want
without discrimination.
Two. Neutrality also means that no matter what telecom operator you're with,
you should be able to access all data on the internet at the exact same speed.
Simply put, just because your telecom company hypothetically has a deal with, like, say, Flipkart,
shouldn't mean that they can make the Amazon website or an independent retailer's website load slower for you.
So slow, in fact, that you eventually give up and you're forced to shop at Flipkart because it's the only one that opens fast.
Except right now, telecom operators want the option of doing exactly that.
Yes.
Which sucks because, let's be honest,
the only thing worse than no internet is slow internet.
Ye chalu kyun ho raha hai? Why is this so?
Telecom operators want to carve up the internet into a bunch of different sections such that you have to pay to access every single one of them separately.
Imagine you go to a children's park and you pay 100 rupees to get it.
And then you head over to a slide because, hey, who doesn't love slides?
But a guy stops you and says, "Sorry, sir, if you want to use this slide, you have to buy the slide access pack, sir, for extra money, you know?"
And so you decide to go on the swings instead, except the same man stops you and he says, "Nope.
To use the swing, you need to buy special swing set pack, sir. Come on, sir."
Okay, fine, yaar. Okay, fine.
You buy access to the swing pack for another 50 bucks, except
when you try to swing fast, the swing refuses to go faster.
Oh, sir, if you want to go fast, you have to pay even more for the high-speed swing pack, sir. Otherwise, sorry, you can't go fast, sir.
At this point, you're probably thinking,
wait, what the hell was that original 100 rupee charge for if I can't even use it to do anything?
Oh, sir, that was just for the privilege of standing on the grass, sir.
In a nutshell, that's exactly what telecom operators want to do right now.
So, want to send a naked picture to strangers on Snapchat?
Buy the Snapchat pack!
Want to show people a picture of khichdi and hashtag the hell out of it on Instagram?
Buy the Instagram pack!
Want to use BBM?
Buy...
Why are you still on BBM?
And it's not just users. The loss of net neutrality hurts you if you're a startup or a fledgling internet business, hypothetically.
Big players like WhatsApp could go to a telecom provider, pay them money and say, well, give people my service or website for free,
but charge the crap out of other people if they want to use this other new guy's sweet little independent service.
Which pretty much puts any competition that doesn't have deep pockets out of business for good.
Why don't more people know about this? And why aren't more people angry about it, man?
A few internet activists have been screaming themselves hoarse about this, but let's face it.
You pay roughly the same amount of attention to an internet activist as Arvind Kejriwal does to an open letter from Prashant Bhushan.
So naughty.
Now, it's not like TRAI is trying to bury the fact that telcos are doing this and praying no one notices.
I mean, to be fair, TRAI has been very helpful and put the issue up on their website
in a 118-page long consultation paper
in size 10 font,
sandwiched between three other links,
while five other images violently distract you with their shitty slide effect.
And the best part is the paper is titled
Consultation Paper for Regulatory Framework for Over-the-Top Services.
First of all, that's a really innocent name to give something that threatening.
If TRAI were to name a nuclear warhead, they would just call it Fluffy.
Also, TRAI put this paper up on the 27th of March.
With a conveniently tight deadline of 24th April to hear any complaints that we might have against it.
And if TRAI doesn't hear enough complaints, they might just go ahead and implement their plan.
Yay.
What are over-the-top services? And, like, why don't telecom companies like them?
Well, let's just look at that super helpful TRAI report for that, huh? The best known examples of OTT are
Skype, WhatsApp, Flipkart, Facebook Messenger, iMessage, Netflix, etc.
According to that paragraph, over-the-top services that telecom operators are overwhelmed by
are social networks, amateur video sites, search engines, and e-commerce sites.
So basically, people who provide you the internet are overwhelmed by
the entire freaking internet.
Netception!
So, why are telecom companies fighting net neutrality?
Simple!
Paisa. Pa-pa-pa-pa.
Paisa.
Telecom tum paisa.
What TRAI is basically saying in that clause is that
telecom providers only make money of data usage but no other revenue from carriage or bandwidth.
On the other hand, apps and websites make a lot of money by sending their data across this bandwidth.
And the telecom operators don't get a cut of that.
Yeah, because you didn't make that app. Or website.
Also, one of the arguments telcos are making is that they pay a shitload of money to build infrastructure to create and maintain these data services.
But then these over-the-top services eat into their revenues,
making it impossible for them to earn their investment back.
But that's just it. Data usage is making telcos money.
For example, in the first 9 months of the current financial year, Airtel's revenue from data usage has grown every single quarter and shows no signs of slowing down.
In fact, at this point, you know, all telecom operators, you can just change your logos from whatever those things are
to a photo of Uncle Scrooge using rolled up money to snort more bits of rolled up money
while sitting on top of a Lehman Brothers executive who is coincidentally pooping money.
Paisa.
But don't telcos just want to protect the law?
Well, here's that TRAI report again. According to the TRAI report, the Cellular Operators Association of India's argument is that you can only provide internet telephony services
if you have a special license under the Indian Telegraph Act of 1885.
Which means that anybody else that offers those services, whether it's Skype, Facebook, whoever, is technically breaking the law.
First of all, the Cellular Operators Association of India sounds like the sort of place where the day you join, you get a free safari suit and a shiny bald spot.
And second of all, if we are being governed by an act that has the date 1885 in the title,
maybe it isn't the OTT services that need to change, but the act itself.
Let me put it this way. If the date of your act falls before the invention of moving image capture itself,
maybe you shouldn't get to regulate video streaming through it. Maybe.
Cut to the chase. What's at stake here?
Your right to use the internet as you have been for the last 20 years.
As an Indian netizen, here's what you should demand.
Freedom. To be able to access information or entertainment on the terms you choose.
Not to be pushed into consumer decisions by large telecom companies who have the trustworthiness of Shakti Kapoor in an 80s movie.
Equality. Because the internet is probably the last frontier where everyone is equal. Where else can Barack Obama post this picture and get this comment?
And lastly, it's about the future, because the internet is a utility, it's not a luxury.
A lot of other countries have already adopted net neutrality, and if India is to progress with them,
an open and free internet is essential.
Okay, so what can I do as a user to stop this? What you need to do right now is log on to www.savetheinternet.in.
All you have to do is log on to the site, type your name and your email address, and with just two clicks, you can send an email to TRAI answering those 20 questions. If you're on mobile, click on the link in the description or on the I button on the top right of the video.
And tweet using the hashtag SaveTheInternet.
And tell your friends and your family and anyone you know who has ever used the internet to do the same.
It's worth it, we promise.
No, don't subscribe. Don't like, don't... No, guys, just send the email.
Do what we said, you know, if you want to not be ripped off by a telecom company or your ISP, just please go ahead and do this.
Just go, you need the internet. If you don't click, you will not, this will not happen very often.
24th April, TikTok.
Stop waiting, mere baal ka halat dekh, like 4 baje ye shoot hua hai din mein. Like seriously, if I can make this video at 4 in the morning sweating, you can log on to the website and send that email to TRAI.
I'm just gonna wait here till you click. Just, I don't know where to be. I'll just wait.